Things are getting more and more exciting. Now we want to understand OData. What the heck is this OData? Before I tell you what it is, I want you to know why we need this. To understand that, we go back to our SharePoint list that we had. You see the items that I have in this list? There are only 6 items. Now imagine the flow that we just developed, and it gets all the items and sends an email for every single item, including the product name, category, unit price, and all those stuff. This time, we want to send the email about only one product, and that one product, the name of the product should be tennis ball. With this approach, yes, we can put a condition here and check the condition for every single item that is read. We can compare the title to a value that we are looking for, and when we find it, we can send it. Let's see how it can happen. Let me add an action here, and this action is going to be condition. We are learning more and more actions. So condition is something like if statement in programming languages. Of course, we don't want to send the email before the condition is checked. So I just click on this send an email and drag and drop it under if yes. So basically, I want to send an email only if one condition that I put here is satisfied. And that one condition should be when the product title is equal to tennis ball. Just be careful if you're doing this one, the compare is case sensitive. So tennis ball should be spelled exactly as it's spelled here. So this one actually works. So let me save it and give it a shot. Let's test it. Click on test. Run flow. Done. Takes a while. I heard the ding for the email. So if I go to my mailbox, the item is already here. So tennis ball sports, and this time it sent only one email. It works. Sure. In this example, we have only 6 products. In real life, you are dealing with probably 6,000 products. Do you still think it makes sense to read 6,000 items from one source, which is inside SharePoint, bring everything inside Flow, and go through them one by one, and finally act on the ones that they are desired? Maybe 1, 2, 10, 15 out of thousands. It really doesn't make sense. This is very inefficient, although works. So what is the right way of doing it? If there is a way that we can go to SharePoint and say, SharePoint, I don't want all the products. Only send me the product that the title is tennis ball. That request is sent to SharePoint using OData. And this is where we need to put the syntax. So basically in the get item, before we really get all the items, let me click on edit and I show you where it is. Under get item, you don't see anything here, but if I click on show advanced options, you will see filter query and OData filter query to restrict the entries return. So basically, if I know the right language, I can write the statement here that goes to SharePoint and only returns the values that they satisfy my conditions. In this example, it can be title equals tennis ball, or it can be like unit price is below $50, or maybe category is electronics. Now, buckle up, because we need to learn how to write OData syntax.